this is the Provoked Prawn, and in this video I'm going to be making it much easier to understand the complexities of wiring up and connecting up Corsair's fans. Now, I have done several different videos in the last few years, various different case builds on all sorts of cases using all sorts of RGB fans from Corsair. You can see one, for example, here in the form of the 7000D, which, as you'll see, has a mass of fans in it. You've got four in the front, four on the side, rear motherboard panel, three on the all-in-one cooler, and one at the rear for exhaust as well. So that's a lot of fans right there. And each of those fans has a power cable and an RGB cable that needs to be connected up in order to run and to show off the RGB lighting. It gets very complicated in those cases, and it can get quite messy with the cables. Now, in each of the build guides that I've done on the Corsair cases, I quite often include a segment on the fan cables and how to wire them up. But to make things a lot easier for you, I'm doing a video now where I'm going to show you all of that installation process outside of the case on the table, and so you can see the logic behind it and how to do it. I'm going to start off with it quite simply with just three fans to show you the simplicity of it at the basic level, and then go through and add more and more fans as I go through the video and show you the different ways to connect it and the things that you might need to bear in mind while doing it. So hopefully this will be a really useful and interesting video if you're considering building in a Corsair case, or if you've ever wondered about how this works and what you're meant to do, because it can be quite intimidating. Even with just three fans, as you can see, you've already got six cables to deal with, and that in itself can look a bit scary if you're new to this or even seasoned veteran. Now, a lot of the Corsair fans have RGB cables and power cables with the labels on it, so now you'll see that one is marked particularly to RGB hub on it. They're also a different style of connector, so it's impossible to get them the wrong way around in terms of which one goes to power and which one goes to RGB, and you can see a close-up look at them here, and I'll show you where they plug in later on, so stick with me for that. That's still a lot of cables though, and the more fans you add in, the more cables you've got to deal with. And you can see that the cables are also the same across all of the different RGB fans. So in this video, you're going to see some samples of LL120s, QL120s, ML120 RGB Pros. I've also done RGB Elite ML120s as well. My first recommendation is make sure if you're purchasing fans, get a triple pack. Get a pack with three fans in it, and you'll get an extra little box that you can see here. This box is pretty much essential to the setup of the RGB as a bare minimum. So make sure you get a triple pack rather than single fans, otherwise you won't have this. This is an RGB controller which is included with Corsair's triple pack fans, and basically this allows you to connect up six fans with RGB connection. As you can see, it has a SATA power and USB connection on it as well, and once again I'll show you where those plug in later on. It also has a 3M sticker so you can stick it to the case. So not too complicated to start with. You have six connectors possible on here, which obviously means only six fans, but this only does the RGB, so only the lighting for the fans can be plugged into this control box, and that then gets plugged into the motherboard and then allows you to control the lighting via Corsair's IQ software. So at a basic level, it's fairly straightforward. If you have just three fans, which we do here, then that box is used to control the RGB lighting, and then a second I'll show you how you control the fan power. The thing to bear in mind here, and the best way to do it, is to work out the logic of where the fans are going to sit in your case. My recommendation at a basic level is to choose where they're going to sit and then try and plug them in order. So the first fan will go into slot number one on the RGB node, and the second fan into slot number two, third fan into slot number three. This makes it a lot easier for the RGB lighting sequencing in IQ and at hardware level, so it just makes things simpler. Now, you can adjust this in IQ software by dragging things around, and they've made it a lot simpler over time, but this makes it really easy if you're doing it this way. It just ensures there's a good logic to it. It's very easy doing it on the desk like this. Obviously, when it's in a case, it becomes a little bit more complicated and a bit more of a pain. However, it is still fairly straightforward, and it just makes your life a little bit more simple, so it's worth doing, worth taking the time to do. So once again, a close-up look at that. Now, you'll note, as I said earlier, it's impossible to plug in the RGB cables into the wrong holes. They are specially designed with a little clip that holds them into place. So once you plug them in, they should just pop in there, and that clip will hold them steady. So now we have the RGB cables plugged in. That's one part of the problem sort of solved, although you do need to make sure that you also plug in the USB connection and the SATA power. So SATA power goes to the flat power connector and that will plug into the power supply unit. So what you're looking for is a cable that looks like this. It's a daisy chainable cable. It's used to connect up hard disk drives and SSDs generally, and also control boxes, fan control boxes, and RGB controllers like this. So you can plug in this single SATA connection and then plug the other end in your power supply unit. Here you can see a sample from the Corsair RM850, and basically that connector plugs into the SATA slash PATA connector on that power supply. You'll find similar connectors on other PSUs as well. It's just a simple look at that. So that's the power connected up. Then you need to connect up the USB. Now it's important not to get the USB connection confused with the front panel USB connection, because it's completely different. But generally most motherboards have two USB connections, and you'll generally find them at the bottom. And this is really straightforward. Again, you can't plug this in the wrong way around. If you look closely at it, you'll see that there is one pin that is basically blanked out, so it's impossible to plug that in wrong. The next part of the process is finding the power connectors. So on your motherboard, you should find some system fan headers. These are ports on the motherboard that you can attach the other cable from the fan into. You should find various different points on the motherboard, and it's worth referring to the motherboard manual to see where they are. But if you look closely, you also see them labeled. So for example, SysFan 1, SysFan 2, and I've got up to 8, I think, on this motherboard. But you may find there are less. There are options if you need more, but you can see that you can find multiple different ones in different points. So at the bottom, on the side, next to the CPU, on the top right, you'll find them in various different positions. Again, check the motherboard manual, but you should see them just written on the motherboard as well, so they're clearly labeled. Don't get those confused with the CPU or pump fan. Those are required for CPU air coolers and for all-in-one coolers as well. So separate, look for the system fan headers if you're using these fans for the case cooling. Then all you need to do is go about plugging in the extra cables. So in this case, we've only got 3 into those various different ports. It doesn't matter which one you use. I found you can basically use any of them. So aim to use the ones that leave the least amount of cables at the front, because obviously you still want to keep things tidy. So you want to minimize how much cable you've got. And obviously, depending on where you've positioned these fans in the case, you might have to stretch the cable. You might have an excess of cable showing if you don't plug them in. But you can see what they look like, a close-up shot of system fan headers down here. And you'll see that there's a little plastic notch and then 4 pins sticking out of those. And so the cables themselves, the plastic on that has a little ridge that runs down. And so you're basically running that into there and connecting these up. This obviously gives your system control of the fan speed, and it also allows you to adjust the fan speed both in the motherboard software and in the BIOS. So the setup process there is fairly straightforward. Now, as you can see, this is a really basic setup for how to install Corsair fans. We've got the RGB 3 RGB hub and the USB and power, and then you just plug in the fan connectors up to the system fan headers. In most cases, you probably won't have just 3 fans. You might well end up with more. So now I'm going to move on to what you do if you have 6 fans. Now, I am mixing and matching fans here just because I don't happen to have 6 LL120s. Corsair does recommend not mixing and matching fans if you can help it. Stick to the same ones. The reason for that is fans will have different airflow, so different types have different airflow capabilities, different max speeds and other things like that. Also, it looks nicer if you get all the same ones and makes life a little less complicated. You can, however, tell IQ software what fans are plugged into what, so you can sort of, it is possible to do, I just wouldn't recommend it, and neither would Corsair. So once you've done that, again, same process to go through. Basically, we're just going to connect up the RGB connectors to the RGB hub and do it again in order. So in this order, I've assumed that the black ones on the right are going on the front of the case and the white ones are going on the top. So I've run them in order from bottom right to the top, 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6 across the top there. Again, the same logic applies now. I'm now just running these fans to the system fan headers on the motherboard. So the power connectors are going into the system fan headers and into the various different spots. You can see it looks a lot messier. There's a lot more cables going on here, but actually the basic process is fairly straightforward. Now, you may find that there are RGB hubs already installed. Some of the Corsair cases have RGB hubs in them. You can see the cables are already connected up here, or at least 4 of them are anyway. And sometimes you'll note there's an extra cable that's coming out of the other side of it. There's 2 different sorts of RGB hub, and the older sort required you to also use this LED node. This has a cable that plugs into it from the RGB hub, and then in itself also connects to USB and SATA power. So that's some extra connections to think about. But the ones that are purchased with the triple packs generally don't have that cable, so it's a little bit simpler. Now I'm adding an extra layer of complexity into it by throwing a Corsair H150i Elite Capalix cooler into the mix. Now I'm going to do what you can do with that with six fans, and that all-in-one cooler comes with a Corsair Commander Core. You can also get a Commander Core XT, which is a newer version. Essentially, this allows for both RGB and fan power control from one control box. Makes life a lot simpler. It has a USB connection and a SATA power connection in the same way as the RGB node, but what it does mean is that you can plug all the fans into that control box in a lot simpler way, because obviously you get plug in each of the power connectors on one side and each of the RGB connectors on the other. Again, use the same logic, basically plug them in the order you want the RGB lighting to go into. But what if you have a lot more fans? What happens if you have this many? Then you have 9 fans, 10 fans, 13 fans. Obviously things suddenly become really complex. Now it's worth noting that the Commander Core comes with the Elite Capalix cooler, but you can also purchase it separately, and I highly recommend doing so, because that then gives you the ability to control the fan power and RGB from one control box. Alternatively, you can also get a Commander Pro. The Commander Pro is slightly different, I'll show you that in a second. That basically only controls fan power, and it has inputs for temperature sensors and for RGB hubs in the way the LED node works, so it doesn't take all the RGB fan connections, but it will take the connection from the RGB control box into it instead as an alternative. But the Commander Core is the easiest thing to do, and you can buy it separately, so you could in theory buy two of these, which would really streamline the process. It is quite an expensive purchase, but as you can see, it makes life a lot easier. In this instance though, what I'm doing is I'm using the Commander Core and then the RGB hub that I was using earlier. So I've plugged in the 6 fans, obviously the black ones on the right and the white ones at the top, into the RGB and fan connections, remembering to do it in order. And then the extra fans, the ones that are left over, are being plugged into the RGB hub instead. That only has the RGB control. Obviously, I'd have to use the system fan headers again for the power connectors. Now, obviously, the RGB hub and the Commander Core both have a USB connection and both have SATA power connections. There are ways to do this, though, because we do have 2 USB connections on the motherboard, but if you throw in a connection from a pump, so from an all-in-one pump, or from some other control box, you suddenly don't have enough USB ports. But as you can see here, you can get USB Y splitters, so a cable that will split 2 USB connections into a single connection that then connect up to the motherboard. I have also used different control boxes like this that I'll link to in the description that are really easy to just plug in multiple different USB connectors into one port. So that makes life a lot simpler and a lot more straightforward. So now we need to plug in the SATA power connections as well. This is a daisy chainable cable that comes from the power supply unit, so you can connect up multiple things to it with ease. In this case, the Commander Core and the RGB hub, but you could put 2 Commander Cores on it, for example, or a Commander Core and a Commander Pro. So here you can see a look at the back of one of the cases. You'll note this is the Commander Core above, and then below that is the Commander Pro. The Commander Pro has 2 USB connections on it, and then it has 1 USB out. So you actually have this as a sort of a Y splitter in itself. It has connection for 6 fan power connections and 2 LEDs. So it works like the LED core that you can see above here, the little one. So you can theoretically run another box into it. It's not quite as good as the Commander Core, but it is good for fan control because you can plug in multiple different devices. So you can see when you have an excess of fans, there are options. This is probably the most simple one. Commander Core controlling 6 fans in both terms of power and RGB, then the RGB hub doing the RGB lighting for the other fans, and then just use your system fan headers for the other ones. Or if you have an excess of fans, let's say 13 fans, for example, you've gone really crazy, or more, then 2 Commander Cores would really make life a lot more straightforward. You can see the complexities of it all, but hopefully I've made your life a little bit simpler in terms of planning out the logic of what to do. Just don't forget, don't mix and match fans, and also consider what's going on in the case. I've done a video recently on the Corsair H100i RGB Pro XT, which was it's a 240mm radiator, but it has a pump with a breakout cable on it where you have the power connections for 2 fans directly connectable to the pump head. So you can connect up your pump directly to two fans that are on the radiator. If you have a cooler like that, and you will find there are others, NZXT for example does it, where they have a breakout cable with three power connections on it, you could theoretically connect up the fans that are on the radiator directly to the pump head and keep them in the closed loop system, and then connect the RGB parts of those fans up to the RGB hub. And that way you're ensuring that the pump has control over not only the pump and the coolant, but also the cooling of the radiator with the fans that are on top of it as well. So lots of different thoughts to go into that, but basically that ensures that the pump radiator fans are separate from the case fans, and if you're using Commander Core or whatever else. Hopefully this has been a useful video to you. Smash that subscribe button if I've helped you out. Hit the like, let me know in the comments if you've got any questions. Also, a special thanks to my YouTube members, Raw, Geralt of Rivia, Sir Spawns a Lot, Meaty Keyboard, Beaster Bunny, Jay Shank 007, Rigsy 79, Star Astons, McFarty, Aaron Yarden, and Chief Howe. Really appreciate their support. If you want to find out the benefits of being a member, click that join button to find out more, and head over to my Discord to let me know how much I've helped you out. Thanks for watching. This has been the Provoked Prawn. Hope you found this video useful, interesting, hilarious, or otherwise. Take a look at these other videos that I think you might find interesting as well. And have a look at the description for links and other information you might find useful. Click that join button to see the benefits of being a member of my YouTube channel. And most importantly, have a great life.